How to get back on track. Last city they.
Just one of my upper body workout variations that I have. I have about three that I do.
I need a burp.
I can say this by experience because, hello, I'm a girl who's gone through an eating disorder and I know how detrimental food play a role on the mind and the body and the way that you are.
Hey everyone, what's up? Welcome to my channel if you guys are new, or welcome back to my channel if you guys are a returning subscriber. And if you guys are new, I would really appreciate if you guys can hit that subscribe button. I upload videos every single 3 days, so I put a lot of effort into my videos. But without further ado, and if you guys are a returning subscriber, thank you so much for stopping by. I really appreciate your support and I love you so much. But without further ado, I'm gonna get into the topic of today's video. I'm half in active wear, half in my PJ still, but I did want to get my lunch prepared and share with you guys why I'm getting my lunch prepared in the way that I am, because it is a bit different than what I'm usually eating throughout the day. Today's video is going to be on how to get back on track, and I'm just going to show you guys the steps where you guys can take to get back on track if you've kind of fallen off the health and fitness bandwagon, and that's totally okay. We go through waves of this, and I recently have passed this weekend. So without further ado, let's get straight into the kitchen, get my lunch prepared, my post-workout meal prepared. I am gonna have proper lunch obviously, and also snack one and two throughout the day. I eat literally about 5 to 6 times a day, so you girls constantly eating. But let's get straight into it. I'm gonna need a better angle. Sorry, you guys always have problems with me and my kitchen.
Oh my god, I hope that's okay for you guys. You guys are literally standing on my stepping stool, which is kind of gross because it's not my counter, but whatever. But this is the protein that I'm going to try out. I've actually been waiting for a little time to be able to try this out because it is best taken post-workout, and you guys know I have my meal preps post-workout, so it really doesn't fit my kind of regime. But for days like this where I'm gonna be filming straight after a workout and I literally don't have time to sit and eat, this is the way to go. So I'm so glad that I got it, but it is the Isoperk Zero Vanilla Ice Cream flavor. And the good thing is that this is, yes, a whey protein, but like other whey proteins that have casein in it, it's not gonna make you bloat because it is pre-digested and fast absorbed into the muscles, which is why it's really good for post-workout. Other than that, it's literally got 0 grams of carbs, it's got added BCAAs in there, and also zero grams of fat, added BCAAs in there, and 1 gram of carbs for 25 grams of protein and 110 calories. Along with that, to make it a little bit more carb dense, I'm going to be adding 40 grams of oats. This is just some quick oats. And then 1 serving of the PB2 Organic. A little bit of sugar-free Natvia strawberry jam. This is like the sh**. And then some Steve's maple syrup. This has got 0 calories in it. So this is my little to-go little packet. Let me whip this all up for you, get it all prepared. I'm also gonna be filming for my stories as well. By the way, how gorgeous are these cases? They're from the city. They sent it to me recently and I have been in love with this. Like honestly, it is freaking amazing. But let me pop you down. Let's get rolling.
The sound of opening up a new protein is just heavenly to me. Okay, we're starting off with just an empty little case. I know I'm gonna get questions about it. I got these little jars from Kmart, and then I have my little peanut butter PB2 Organic with 40 grams of oats, 41 grams to be precise. So we're gonna be adding that in there. Just enough water to cover it. Maybe a little bit more because of the protein. And then some Steve's maple syrup. I already like finished one. Listen, if it's 0 calories, you really don't need to think about it, right? And then just some Natvia, what's it called? Strawberry jam. Don't worry about it, we are all gonna be mixing that together. And then I'm going to be adding, and in goes your protein. Love that for me. And then very lastly, before I do anything, I actually do want to give that a stir. Very lastly, you add your PB2 Organic. Oh, she looks great already. And she smells so good. And then very lastly, you want to be adding the peanut butter or PB2. I can eat this all day. Oh my god, you are gorgeous. Okay. Again, give her a good stir. She's gonna taste so good. Leave that in the fridge for a few hours or overnight, and then have it when you're done. I like to heat mine up before I have it, so that's gonna be a lovely little treat post-workout.
Alrighty, in she goes into the fridge for a few hours while I get ready, and then we will definitely have this post-workout. I think for lunch I also have just some chicken, broccoli. Let me actually show you.
So I've got some lettuce, some chicken, and some potatoes for a little snack after I'm done when I come back home, and then definitely snack one and two later on. But yum, how good does that look? Got my two little lunches, one and two.
Okay, we're starting off another workout. So today I'll be filming my upper body workout for you guys, or just one of my upper body workout variations that I have. I have about three that I do consistently every single week. Starting off with lateral pull downs. If you want to be having a wider back, which is what I'm aiming for the X figure, so the smaller waist, bigger shoulders and bigger hips and bigger butt. I go for a wide hold lateral pull down and I just decrease my weights. I start off with my heaviest weight and then decrease my weights with each set. We do a set of 10 reps by 4 sets. So we do this for 4 rounds. And as you can see, you want to be keeping your tummy tight and pulling in towards your chest. So you want the bar to be right on top of your boobs or right on top of your nipples, if you will. And then the next exercise is going to be the seated low row. With this one, you want to be pulling the weights or pulling it towards your under chest, so towards your abdomen. I work with, I think it was about 23 kilos for this one. No, sorry, 26 kilos for a set of 10 reps. And we do 4 sets of this one. As you can see, it's working out my shoulder muscles and my back muscles. You need to be remembering to suck in your tummy, keeping that tense, and also pulling it all the way through to your back. So keeping your back tight with each pull. My last rep for this is always slow and steady, so time under tension is very important over here. And then the next exercise is a bent over row. So I started off with 15 kilos and worked my way up with each set. So I worked up by 5 kilos. Over here, you want to be bending your knees slightly and also keeping your back very straight with your head looking downward. So that spine and your back should be completely as straight as you can keep it to isolate your shoulders and your back. You want to be pulling towards your nipples. Sorry about my language, but that's what it is. Pulling towards the nipples or pulling towards your chest and keeping your stomach again tight, with your back tight as well. You should only be feeling this in your back. If you're feeling it in your lower back, then you should be either bending down a little bit more or going up a little bit more, depending on how comfortable you feel with the exercise. And then we'll be doing some hyperextensions. With this, you keep your back isolated by keeping your feet sturdy. And then you want to be isolating your back, holding a 10 kilo. Well, for me, 10 kilos is probably my medium weight range. I can probably do about 15 to 20. I wanted to keep it really light for the video, so I don't look like I'm struggling, let's be real. So I did 2 sets with 10 kilos of 10 reps, and then I switched to 5 kilos for 2 sets of 10 reps. Again, I am keeping my highest weight at my first set. This is going to be showing the maximum effort with my highest weight, whereas if I was working my weight upwards, I would be showing minimum effort with my maximum weight. And this is just the way that I like to train. For this one, we are doing lateral arm raises, single arm raises, and I just used 5 kilos for 10 reps of 4 sets. This one just works your shoulders and is really, really good for sculpting out your shoulders and also sculpting out a little bit of your chest and collarbones as well. And I did struggle on this one, to be honest. This one, it got cut off in the video, but we're doing a seated dumbbell shoulder press. And with this one, you want to be working first at the beginning with the dumbbells on either side of your shoulders, holding them just the way that I am, and then lifting it up, connecting the two together, but not allowing the dumbbells to touch. So that was my complete workout routine for my upper body, just one of my upper body days. Obviously, I will be including a lot of these into my regime where I just put voiceovers over the workout, because I find it that you guys really like this type of content and me explaining the workouts rather than just putting a, you know, music over the top of it. But enjoy the rest
I'm out of the gym. There's actually people looking at me right now, but you know what? I really don't care because I'm trying to get the content for you guys. Like this guy that's just walking past. Oh my god, how embarrassing. But this is the protein oats that I made. I just heated it up at the gym before I left, so after my session, and it smells amazing. So love that for me. She smells great. My mouth is literally watering. Can't say no to food. Wait, I need a burp. All right, let's go. If I had closed my eyes and tasted this, all I can taste is vanilla ice cream with a hint of strawberry. This is amazing. Am I scared of eating whey protein? Nah, girlfriend, because you know why? Fast absorbing, pre-digested, non-bloating. Perfect for after a workout, straight after a workout. All right, I'm going to have this on the way to location one for some content. And the reason why also this as well, not for the fact that I bloat, but like quick, easy, pre-digested, do you know what I mean? You got your carbs in there, you got your good fats in there, because like the peanut butter, focus on me for once, thanks mate. And also the protein in there because of the isopept. Is there other flavors of that? Like if this flavor is that good, vanilla, very versatile she is, very, very tasty she is. You are amazing. All right, I'm gonna go get my content. When I'm ready, we shall talk about the steps that you can take to get back on track.
End of week little top up. These are my favorite cereals. So I got the Choc Bombs and then also the Rice Pots. I love them in my protein shakes or in cereal, protein cereal. B2B Halo Top Ice Cream, loving this one. And I've incorporated the full dairy ones now and I have no problems whatsoever. And then we got the brownie batter one. This is my favorite pasta. Absolutely love it. And this is my second tub of this, guys. I absolutely freaking love this. But that's just like an overall of just an end of week kind of mini top up.
So I'm gonna have some lunch. I've got some potatoes, broccoli, and some chicken. And I just had a shower, cleaned the entire house. And I'm gonna do a little bit of baking. And you guys would have probably already seen this on Instagram, I'm guessing. I don't know when I'm gonna upload it. If it turns out, I'm gonna upload it. I'm putting down the basket full of toys because when I clean, I pop everything up onto like the benches and everything. Let me show you my ingredients, and then if it turns out, I'll show you guys how it is, and also like leave a little recipe card over here for you, or like leave the reel for you guys to watch in the next slide or something. I don't know. I'll come up with something, but let me show you my ingredients.
So that's my lunch over there. I'm gonna be snacking on that while I go, but I'm gonna have 100 grams of oats, 40 grams of choc chips, these are the Notion choc chip, 3 servings of P2B, 2 small bananas, and also 2 servings of the Blessed protein. And then I'm going to add in 60 mils of this no sugar Natvia chocolate sauce to like combine it. Bake it on 180 for like 15 to 20 minutes. And when it turns out, I'll show you how it is. Oh, you know what? Forget it. I'm going to pop in the reel in the next slide. I've been having dreams, splashing in the summer stream, tripping, I fall in. I wanted it to happen. My body turns to ice, crushing weight of paradise. Solid block of gold, lying in the cold. I feel. And this is how they turned out. How amazing, hey? 132 calories in them. Let me just get the macros for you. 132 calories, 4.2 grams of fat, 9.4 grams of protein, and 13.5 grams of carbs. And that's all good carbs, because you've got your banana and your oats. This is amazing. Yeah.
So I was actually editing this video right now. Oreo, stop that. Stop licking your paws, love. I was actually editing this video right now and I realized I didn't even film a sit down talk section of how to actually get back on track, which is what the whole video is about. Hang on, I'm gonna get my heater because it's absolutely freezing. Like I have not been able to get warm lately, especially like last night. It was what, 11 degrees? And it was so cold.
But I just wanted to pop in and kind of talk about ways that you guys can get back on track. So I'm actually in the middle of filming another video, but I want to pop in here and just quickly, you know, get it all done for you guys before anything, before all of your training, before absolutely anything. You guys need to clean up your habits within your four walls, meaning within under your roof, within your home. And what I mean by that is, number one, your fridge, number two, the foods that you cook. So I'm currently going to meal prep and I'm gonna film it for another YouTube video that will go up after this one. But every single Sunday or Monday, or even sometimes on a Saturday, where within those 3 days, I would always bake something like a good treat, and I'll show you two that I have made, and you guys will see this on my Instagram anyway. These are number one. These are just like my little Rice Krispies, and I basically keep these in the freezer. They're like, think of LCM bars made with protein, and then when I wanna eat it, I thaw it out, and is that gonna focus? I thaw it out and I consume it like that with a little bit of PB2, and I'm gonna get into why you wanna make all of this stuff and put this much effort into it. And then the other thing that I also made today is my protein banana bread. So double choc cookie protein banana bread that I made. I'll pop a photo over here of it. Because I'm a sweet tooth, I always tend to go for something sweet at the end of the night. Whether this is my pancakes, whether this is my halo chop, whether this is my macro hot donuts, whether this is my protein custard with a bit of cereal on top, or just some cereal with a bit of protein on top, or something that I've baked. And because I'm the type of person who will go for anything if there's nothing, like I have to have something sweet because I just can't give in to my cravings. I have to make this time throughout the week and prepare something like a good little treat throughout the week for me to be able to snack on. Now, if I don't have them, I'll definitely have some protein bars on hand. And the reason why I'm talking about food first before anything is because what your body is and the body composition that you have at the moment and the fat percentage, the muscle percentage on your body at the moment is because of what you eat. Yes, number one, training does help, but the first and foremost thing is the what you consume and what you put inside your body. So you want to be able to make at least 1 day a week, 2 hours out of that 1 day a week, where you just meal prep stuff like this, where you just cut up some vegetables and do a little bit of meal prep at home. Or what I personally like to do is do a bit of food prep. So I will get like a bunch of veggies baked, or I'll make a stir fry, or I'll poach some chicken, or I'll, you know, fry some chicken with some Nando's sauce that I love, that is completely amazing and clean, and you don't need anything else but that sauce, that I can whip up into single, you know, food items like chicken. And then I'll have some corn in the fridge, boiled corn cobs in the fridge, or some corn kernels, or boiled peas in the fridge, boiled potatoes in the fridge, that I can make a meal of when needed. So I will make up my lunches like this, or I will make up my dinners like this. This is number one, going to help you with all of your goals, whether it's weight loss, whether it's weight gain, whether it is just eating clean and healthy and having that 1 or 2 days occasionally where you do give yourself a little bit of a treat. Like for example, go have a pizza once in a while, or go have McDonald's once in a while if that's what you like. But I'm just telling you guys a way that you guys can get back on track and feel your utmost best within your body and within your mind and your soul. So spend 1 day a week, 2 hours out of that 1 day, just meal prepping or food prepping. The second thing you want to do is make a regime for yourself. So cut out all the bad habits, write it on a piece of paper, and day by day eliminate one bad habit that you have and replace it something with good. For example, sleeping in. If you sleep until 11 o'clock, switch it. Wake up at 10, then cut it back. Wake up at 9 a week later, then wake up at 8 a week later. Or if you find yourself just slouching down on the couch, when you find yourself, get up off the couch, do a few squats, go for a walk. If you've got a dog, take your dog out for a walk. If you think you're having too many fizzy drinks, switch it up. Have the zero, or have the diet version of it, or the no sugar version of it. For example, my sister and my cousins are of people who absolutely every single day without a doubt, I'm not too sure if my sister has it anymore, but I'm 100% sure she used to have Pepsi and Coke. And the girls, my cousins, always have a V every single day. What they do now though, they have switched that up and have the sugar free version of it. So they're still enjoying their V. And you guys know that I usually, occasionally when I need it, have a sugar-free V or a sugar-free Mother or sugar-free Pepsi Max or something like that, or a Coke Zero or something. I'm not the type of person who likes fizzy drinks anymore. I mean, I did go through 1 month where I cut it out, and then now even when I have like a sip of Ned's drinks, it just tastes like chemical to me. I really don't like it. So either eliminate it, cut yourself down for at least 2 weeks, and then later on you're gonna see that you actually don't like it and that your taste buds are just accustomated to what they are. Lollies, chips, switch it up. If you're a person who likes some chips, Smith's salted vinegar chips, switch
it up. Have a protein chips instead, or if you're a person who likes Doritos, my favorite go-to is the Quest chips. I love them. Love them with a bit of cottage cheese or a bit of hummus or guacamole next to it. Amazing. You guys can even make taco nacho balls out of it. So switch up your foods. There's always an alternative, a healthier alternative for what you like. Another thing is, you know, chocolate. I'm a person who cannot say no to chocolate. I just can't say no. Nutella, my biggest downfall, biggest bloody downfall, and peanut butter. This is gonna be the bad ones that I used to love and have, and this is gonna be what I switched up in that's going to accustomate and, you know, complement my body goals at the moment. So there is always an alternative. Number three, what you wanna be doing is making a habit or a routine to get into. Now, the reason why I talked about food first is because food and nutrition is what makes your body, what makes your mind and your soul. It determines how you feel, your mood, your character even. And I can say this by experience because, hello, I'm a girl who's gone through an eating disorder, and I know how detrimental food can play a role on the mind and the body and the way that you are and who you are, what your character is, how you act, how you respond to things, what relationships you make or break. So that's the reason why I talked about food and nutrition first. Number three is putting yourself into a routine or creating a habit out of a routine. I'm the type of person who gets up at literally 4:30 on the dot or 4 o'clock every single morning, and I've made that a habit. That's my body clock. Some people think that's too early, but you know what, for me that's perfect. I get a head start into my day and finish everything that I want to in the day, because hashtag your girl's a bloody workaholic and it kills my life, but I love it and I won't have it any other way. But make a routine for yourself. So I've made it a routine to get up at 4:30 in the morning and just do my little house chores, get my lunch prepared, get my husband's lunch prepared. My husband's very needy. He even needs his hair done in the morning and his smoothie blended and his lunch prepared and all of his snacks prepared. Literally put it in front of the door and head out. That's the only way he will do it, or else he will become a very unhealthy person if I wasn't in his life. And I think that's why he got married to me, actually. But yeah, I just made that a habit for myself. So after that, after getting all of my house stuff done, I'll get ready for the day and head off to the gym. Every single day, 6 days a week, I will head to the gym and do an at least 30 minute workout. Just move my body in some sort of way. I'll do HIIT twice a week, get on the treadmill twice a week, do some abs twice a week, and I'm weightlifting 3 times a week, either upper or lower body. So get into the routine of moving your body, and trust me, you're going to love it, and you're going to come back and you're going to say, hey Nat, thanks, I needed that. And it's really, really done good for my days. It's done good for my mind, my body, and my soul. I'm not only saying this so you guys can lose weight or tone down or gain weight or whatever your goals are. I'm saying it just to clear up your mind, body, and soul, and, you know, get into the habit of having a healthier, active, more, you know, active lifestyle in a way. Number four, there's only going to be about 5 tips. Number four is going to be clearing up your mind. So stress, and I know this is so freaking cliche, just thinking like, don't stress. No, but honestly, it really does play the biggest part in who you are and what your goals are, and it does play the biggest part in everything got to do with your hormones, because thyroid is a stress hormone and cortisol obviously is your stress levels. So having an increased amount of stress in the body is going to increase your thyroid, which is going to then make your body go against whatever you're doing. This could be gaining weight, this could be putting on muscle, this could be losing weight, toning down, anything. Not only that, it is unhealthy, it's toxic for the body. You're literally poisoning yourself with it. So I know it's easier said than done, but try your hardest to at least take one day a week. Like my Sundays, nobody can bug me at all. No family, no friends, nothing. No one can bug me, not my clients, no one. Because Sundays are my days where I just reset everything in my head, and I let go of everything in my head for that one day. Get my shit done in the house, you know, be a housewife, cook, clean, do some editing, whatever I want to do, and reset my mind, my body, and my soul. And that's just the way I like it. Some people, like Ned's friend, loves to go swimming. Every week he'll go for a swim at the gym, or he'll go into the sauna, because he's lived such a stressful life with work and everything, so he needs that one day a week to regroup everything. So tip number four is going to be getting rid of stress, or finding a way to make stress more capable. So getting that one day a week for yourself, whether it's just soaking in a bath with some Epsom salt in it or magnesium flakes in it or whatever. Tip number five, and my last tip for this video, is going to be clearing up your space. Having a very crowded, overdone up space or overly messy space is going to impact your life so, so much. You're not going to get anything done. You're not going to want to get off the lounge. You're not going to want to do anything. Like I said, every Sunday I'll clean up my house, and that's just a reset to my entire week, and that helps a lot, or else this house would be an absolute shit show. But what I've done is made my house pretty enough so when I come here, it's like my sanctuary. It's like where all of my creative ideas come into my head. I put plants all over the place. I've put, you know, cute little decorations all over the place. Things that's gonna look good to my eye. My husband turned around and said to me, why'd you buy so many plants? Because it doesn't understand the emotional and mental aspect of it. It's like, this is my house. This is the place that I call safe and that is special to me and that I come back to every day looking forward to it, and it's nice and clean and it's crisp. Do you know what I mean? So those are the five things that I like to do. And also a little bonus one is keeping a fridge full of healthy food and all of that stuff, but that goes into the nutrition part of it. So that's the number one point of it. But those are just the five things that I like to do to get back on track, not only with my physical aspect of everything, but also the biggest part is the mental aspect and how I'm feeling. So I hope you guys did enjoy this video. If you guys like this video, please don't forget to give it a like. Don't forget to share it with your friends and family. And also don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos because I upload every single 3 days. And if you guys have any video suggestions, please don't hesitate to leave them in the comments down below. I'll see you guys in the next 3 days. Bye.